Alright guys, welcome back to another episode with CRP. Today we are running the unmarked Trackhawk. It's a rather wet and miserable day, but it's all good. I hope you guys have been well. I've been doing alright. Had a rather productive weekend with Laura. Getting some fire alarms fitted at her house and making sure the kittens are okay. She's going to be making a vet call tomorrow because one of the kittens appears to have had a quite serious hernia. It's okay, it's not in any pain or suffering, but yeah, it's just not the ideal situation, especially for a kitten so young. So yeah, first week back at work last week, that was fun, and then I've got quite a lot of stuff to do in relation to, well, a couple of life changes in my personal routine, guys. But yeah, other than that, same old, same old. Nothing much has changed all too much, aside from, well, the changes I will be implementing as of basically tomorrow. So yeah, should be fun, guys, should be fun. I will keep you all posted the further along I get, but yeah, for now we'll just keep it on the down low and just enjoy patrol today. We have started this patrol a touch late, but that's okay. Like I said, one of the reasons why I prefer not going live anymore is just due to being able to then be a lot more flexible with my routine and go from there, really. Alright, we're going to get out of the way of this guy. We're going to get this guy out our way, rather. I believe we've got something going on at the minute, but it's fairly low-key, so yeah. We'll see what pops off and go from there, I suppose.
Traffic stop's going to be code 4, show all units on scene, back 10-8, no further action.
Oh, and just like that, it's now sunny. That's convenient. Oh, hello. Okay, what the hell was that? Lag spike. I imagine I'm somewhere in the vicinity of the traffic stop if that's... Oh, yeah. There it is. Gervais towing on scene as well. We got BCSO. Sam's in the Audi. Oh. Give me one sec, guys. Hello.
Hey, Director.
How's it going, Sam?
Are you able to investigate a 911 call we've had? The vehicle, the reason the vehicle was pulled over initially is it was reported stolen by someone perpetrating to be the RO, but the person we've just stopped in the vehicle is the RO and claims she hasn't reported the vehicle stolen.
Yeah, I mean, we can get Samcom to do a backtrack on it. Give me one sec. Oh, have you left this traffic stop scene?
No, we're clear back tonight. There's nothing further to hold her on, so.
Yeah, no, fair enough then. I'd advise getting Sancom to go call back on the vehicle in question, to be honest.
Yeah, sounds good. She mentioned that her ex may have reported it stolen, because
right,
apparently she's had issues with him in the past, but it's all registered to her, she's all valid, insured, license is clear.
Do we know who her ex is?
That was the issue. I can have a look on the system.
Yeah.
Give me just a second.
Incoming
911.
God fucking damn it.
Intelligence report for Seoul. Mr. Camp. Esteban Camp.
Ah.
I believe.
Right. One second.
warning, violent.
It doesn't explicitly say that, but it doesn't. It's the only name that's mentioned, and given that it's an accusation that she shot him, that seems to line up.
Wait, she shot him?
It's an accusation.
Right.
Wanted for questioning, that bolo's closed. Yeah, Esteban Camp there. That we really need more information on the relationship between the two of them. Anything on that?
I would have grilled her a little bit more on while he still had her, mate, but if she's already gone, then won't worry about it too much for now.
Here we go. APB 3712 closed.
14 myself and A31, I'm going to be en route to the latest 911.
Mr. Camp then said they were trying to get away from this individual.
Copy 410, thank you. Sorry, Sam, go on.
Mr. Camp then said they were trying to get away from this individual who identified as Chelsea Vicious. After their first date, Miss Vicious reportedly locked Mr. Camp in their home and abused them. It's Esteban Camp.
Interesting.
Supposedly.
I'll be honest.
Sam, trace the number and see if there's a record of it anyway.
Yeah, I'll be honest, mate. It just sounds like they're just toxic exes.
X31's going to be on soon.
Yeah, no, see, I'd let it go if it's just like a casual 911 call, but if it's you're falsely reporting a stolen vehicle, then that's something I'll at least have SANCOM see if we can get a name for.
Yeah. No, that's fair enough. Alright, yeah. Get in touch with SANCOM, get to do a callback or a trace, and then go from there.
Yeah, if I get anything, I might just... yeah.
Yeah, just let me know, mate.
Is that a... what is...
Actually, I want your one county medic down this way, please. We've got a female in a what looks to be a van humped over the wheel.
Chop the one, I'll push county medic 6 to you.
Is misuse of a 911 system a infraction, misdemeanor, or felony? Do you know off the top of your head?
Let me search up now and find out. I believe it's a felony. Now, misuse of a controlled substance, hang on. Misuse of 911, there it is. Misdemeanor, $500 fine and a week in jail. Ow. I've just seen in the penal code it's misuse of 911.
Oh, good.
Yeah. I need to correct that.
I don't think we have a harassment charge, but it's only been once, so whilst it could technically constitute harassment,
81410, can you just confirm, please, that if it happens more than once,
then it can constitute as harassment.
Yeah. I'll see what SANCOM get. If they get something, I might clitoral to the location in an unmarked just to scope it out.
Yeah, sounds good, mate.
Yeah, right, I'll let you know.
Alright, dude.
In a bit.
Yeah, in a bit. Oh, that's good.
X-81. Send.
The individual is stating that there is a local that struck the van, which then struck the Gervais sound truck.
Copy. County medics are showing up now, as well as the Casey's towing truck, so this vehicle is going to be clear.
Charlie 1, I'm just about to put a lane closure on lane 2. You want me to still go ahead with that or cancel?
You go ahead and cancel it. We're going to be off to the shoulder. We're going to be well clear of the vehicles, and I put my vehicle in a spot where it would have to get hit first.
Good copy.
Local just flew up on me and like slowed up for the traffic and
yeah, I get it. I seen you drive by us just a couple minutes ago. Sure, you seen that we had a little incident going on, so that was probably a little too excited to finally get let through. But if nobody else has anything for you, I'm good to go, honestly.
No, I'm good.
I'm good.
There will be a report that's going to be put out. I'm not able to give you exactly when, but you'll be able to pick up the report within the next 72 hours just for your insurance sake and also for the company.
Yeah, I'm aware of your y'all's processes.
Yeah. Which, with it being a company, I can also email it to whoever you'd like for me to email it to. And then they can just head to a station and they already have a report number and all that to get a copy of it.
Yeah, whatever. It doesn't matter.
Alrighty.
I mean, I'm the CEO and whatever else, owner, CFO, whatever, all the fancy.
Oh, even better.
Terminology.
I'm sure you probably have an email or something on the website, right?
Website?
You don't have a website?
Shit, no.
You're on social media.
Got a Twitter account I don't really look after.
Ah. I'll just find it in the phone book, then.
Yeah, we're old.
Really,
we're
should
old
really
school.
Get, you should really get a website set up.
Or social
really
media, something.
Yeah, man. Really help the profit go up.
Yeah, I'll have to talk with Rob about it. He's more, I think, technology savvy than I am. All I'm good for is how to take apart a sniper rifle and put it back together.
On that note, you probably shouldn't finish. You probably shouldn't continue that conversation. So.
No, that.
On that note.
No, I don't shoot.
Right. You have a busted out indicator, sir.
Thank you.
Alright, guys. Do a quick check around the U-tool. Right, everything's all good there. Head back out. Excuse me. Excuse me, bloody hell. Right. Sorry guys, I don't know what's up with me. I've just had a pasta with cheese, so. I'll be honest, I'm dead surprised that the Wraith is picking up the speeds at such an angle. Come on, bro. Yikes. Ooh. don't know why that bunny started hopping towards my car. It'd be the suicide bunny from the Suicide Bunny books. I'm not sure if you guys have heard of the Suicide Bunny series, but it's quite a funny series, to be fair. Slowest overtake known to mankind. I love the fact that that actually worked. Just get in front of that dilettante like that. Whatever. That car. That knockoff Prius. I'll be honest, a single solid line, I'm not sure if overtaking on that is legal or not, but we don't have single solid lines here in the UK, so, well, not as divider lines anyway, so I'm just going to treat it as a single broken line until I get educated otherwise.
Incoming 911.
Charlie 1, I'll be on route to that Lotus 911.
6911, stay around the block, down the road at 4:30 people.
Be advised, I'll be on route from North Kalafki Road.
Charlie, we're back to 19, you're around that well, I think.
Yes. Tell the one I'm out with the individual you've got here. Hey, mate, stop there for a sec for me, please. You just been involved with the incident at the 24/7.
Yeah.
Okay. What's
here?
Okay. What's happened, mate?
Fat dude, orange shirt, walks in. You know, greet him like normal. I think he put something in his pants.
Okay.
And then he comes over to the register and says, give me all the pesos in the register. And I'm like, we don't have pesos. So he's like, give me all the money. You know, he doesn't look like he has a weapon, so I'm just like, going back and forth, get bored of it, press a button. I punch him back and we throw a few punches till he runs out.
Okay. Okay, mate. Real quick, can I just get your name, please?
Name is Garrett Mason.
And how are you spelling that, with two T's?
Two R's,
okay.
Yeah.
I was gonna say, I thought you looked familiar.
Ireland, mental health, drugs, theft,
I've had a few
robbery, re-offender, parole.
Yeah, the amount of bloody, it's the amount of markers you got on you, I would say so. You on parole?
Yeah.
What are you on parole for?
There was an incident, so, yeah.
Okay. Right, okay, no worries. And you working at this address, are you?
Yeah, I'm just working for 24/7. They have me over here today. Sometimes they switch me around depending on where they need me.
Okay, mate. I've got your phone number, so... Hang on, I think they got the guy stopped.
Sure,
one, have we got this guy stopped? Be advised, I believe so. I've got the store worker here with me now. They're advising that he may have shoved something down his pants, and that he's also attempted to rob them. Tried to tell the store attendant to give them all the pesos that they had. So, yeah, take with that what you will. All right, what was it you believe he stuffed down his pants again?
410-101.
Oh, hang on one sec. Sam, if you could get this guy's account for me real quick, please.
Yeah, can I?
410, go ahead.
Step over it for us.
Do you mind confirming if this gentleman with the orange t-shirt stole a jar of mayo and put it down his pants?
Stand by, I'll confirm for you now.
Stand for, thank you.
Yeah, store attendant saying it was a jar of something.
Okay.
Stand for.
Right,
he didn't show any weapon or anything, but he kept saying, at first, pesos, and then he said, give me all the money in the register, and I was like, no.
Okay, well, why don't we start from the beginning, so what happened? How did he turn up? Let's start
with that. Bicycle, pulled up on a bicycle, walked in, greeted him like I greet everybody. He goes, and it looks like he stuffed something in his pants, so I was looking in the little round mirror up at the corner. He comes over, I ask him what he put in his pants, he said nothing. He tells me to give him all the pesos in the register. I tell him we don't have pesos, so he switched to just give me all the money in the register. I tell him no, we go back and forth for a minute. I press the little button, he comes over, punches me, so we exchange a few punches.
I'll be right back.
So you said, so hold on, he asked for all the pesos, you told him...
Listen, I can't count those for there are two for one time, so I got a bicycle.
Told him no. Went back and forth about it for a second. I pressed the little button to call you guys down. And he came over, punched me. I punched him back. We exchanged punches. He ran out. I ran after him.
Okay. Is that motorcycle yours or his?
It's a friend of mine's.
Okay.
Borrowed it to get here.
Okay, no worries. Do you have a registration sticker on it at all?
Yeah.
Okay, where is it, or what is it for me, please?
Sorry, what was that?
What's the registration sticker on it? What's the number for it, please?
Oh, I don't know it by heart. I could go and look for you.
If you wouldn't mind, please, just because I was... If that... Well, actually, it's not important for now, actually. We'll leave it for now.
Okay.
I will want to check that later, if that's alright with you.
Yeah.
Cool.
My roommate's bike. he lets me borrow it if I have to travel farther for work.
Gotcha. When this guy assaulted you, you say he punched you at all?
Yeah, he came over to the, over the side of the counter and he punched me, so I punched him right back.
Okay.
We punched each other a few times.
Okay, where did you punch him?
Face.
Okay. Dollar 1410. Do me a favor if you can you just check your individual's knuckles, please, and also his face for any potential bruising. Store attendants advising there's been some back and forth, both verbally and physically, with each other.
10 broad copy, X-ray 99, do you copy?
10 for all up here, everyone,
what's on the 20%. Do you want me to email you a copy of these notes directly?
Can do if you want, Sam.
It's the BCSO cars being BCSO cars.
Mm-hmm.
He's got no bruising on him.
None at all?
Nope.
Okay.
I'm trying to figure out what I can get him with, because all I can see currently in my listing for anything is petty theft, rather than just generic theft, which is an infraction, no jail time. He did fail to yield to me, though, and then decided to go into a liquor store, so at that point I was not playing around, I held a gunpoint, at which point he decided to question my existence.
Right,
like an idiot.
Okay, tell you what.
So, could I get him with resisting?
Yes, you could. Also, Mr. Mason, if you wouldn't mind, can you just show me to your CCTV systems? Then we can just make sure we got definite conviction on what charges we're going to go with for this gentleman.
I did admit to trying to rob the place for money, or sorry, for peso.
Right, okay. Because he's also assaulted the store worker here, apparently, so.
Oh, even better. I'll add that to my list of charges of assault.
Yeah, right.
That's more stuff.
Alright, there you can watch it.
Cheers, thank you.
Assume it's more than $5, but I think that's our minimum before we consider petty theft. That might be informal, though.
What are you saying back there, Sam?
Do we have a minimum before we charge for petty theft?
No, mate. As far as I'm aware, I would say I mean,
I know we usually don't if it's like less than $5, but I suppose in this circumstance that really goes out the window anyway.
Yeah, I mean, to be honest, with the assault, I would just upgrade it to theft anyways, which is any item under the value of $1,000, mate.
Okay.
If you really want to, I've already got a rundown of what's really going on, which is he's just still getting arrested for theft because he's admitted to trying to rob this place.
Oh, good.
I mean, he wanted all the money out of the registers, so I could get him for grand theft if I really wanted to.
I mean, technically asking for all the pesos in the register is asking for nothing, but...
Well, I just don't know. It's mine. Pesos is money, therefore he wants everything in the register, so in his mind it is...
Alright. Okay, just give me a sec.
If I walk up to the hotel and there's cash in your wallet, I'm not saying dollars and pounds, but I'm still wrapping up the money.
Oh, I'm not arguing with you, I'm just pointing out that if he's asking for pesos, he's asking for nothing.
Awesome. Alright, appreciate that, Mr. Mason. Cool.
He is intending to take all among the register. That's right. What I'm saying, though, Sam.
Yeah. Okay, so
complicating it.
Right. So we've definitely gone for theft. We've definitely gone for
hit a seagull.
Yeah, we've definitely gone for theft. We've definitely gone for assault. We've definitely got him. Well, for attempted robbery, anyways. Hello.
You alive?
Oh yeah. Sorry. We've definitely gone for assault. We've definitely got him for theft. Or petty theft, either or. And then we've also gone for attempted robbery. So, he's actually come behind the counter trying to get to the till, and he's assaulted the store attendant while he's been trying to get to the till, so.
We don't have attempted robbery in this.
Have we got robbery?
Yes.
So, in this aspect...
drop it from a felony to a misdemeanor?
Well, no, in this aspect, actually, I'd say drop the theft charge altogether and make it a robbery. Because technically, robbery doesn't actually quantify what the item is. It could be money or it could be something else. Because he's actually assaulted the worker in the process, you could make that a robbery charge, technically speaking.
Alright, so resisting arrest because he already questioned me trying to put him in cuffs for one and two, going from here all the way up to the liquor store outside of the...
Yeah. Sorry, no, we can't make a robbery charge because it's not been taken off the person, it's been taken out of the premises. So, yeah, now it would have to be a theft charge.
Joy, so the only thing you'll actually be getting is resisting arrest and assault.
Yeah, we'll get him for theft and assault then.
Petty theft.
We don't have a standard theft charge. It's just petty or grand.
Right. Okay. We'll go with petty theft then.
Petty theft also says from another person.
Okay. Well, there you go then. So
I'll let the court worry about that.
Yeah. Generally, theft is universal because you can take it from a person. Like, but generally theft is either from a person or premises, and then robbery is basically from a person by force, or from a premises by force, I suppose, actually.
Robbery is the charge we're looking for. The taking or carrying away with the intent to steal anything of value in the care, custody, control, management, or possession of any store, bank, or financial institution. So we do want robbery.
Actually, yeah, no, we do want robbery then.
Oh my god.
No, that works though, because that brings it up to a felony, doesn't it? From petty theft. Yes.
Felony, 3 months, 3,000.
3 months prison, assault 1 month, was a misdemeanor, and then 3 months because he was resisting.
Right, so we're happy with the robbery, happy with the assault, so we're going to drop the petty theft.
Just drop the assault and put it first degree robbery, a robbery in which the victim, a hostage, or third party otherwise uninvolved in the crime is physically uninjured.
Have you got the fucking...
Yes.
You've got it open on your dictionary, haven't you?
Yes, I've got it on my brain.
You're nice. A pain in the ass sometimes, Sam.
Hey, I'm being useful, leave me alone.
Yeah, I was about to say, you're actually, useful? He is being useful.
I'd have it up on my phone, but I tried and it, because I had to press the other button that makes me grab my radio, it went no. So I just decided, you know what.
So, now he's got 5 months prison.
Yeah.
There you go, happy days.
Yeah, what is it? 5 months prison, $5,000 plus $1,000 restitution.
Mm. Right, Mr. Mason, just because obviously you've been assaulted in this case, although SADPS and BCSO will go ahead with a robbery charge, are you wanting to press charge it or additional charges for the assault as well?
Is it going to confuse you guys more? Because I got confused listening to you guys.
No, it's purely just if you want to add it on or not.
Yeah, sure.
It means cool. He has more prison time.
Yeah, so robbery and assault then. Happy with that?
First degree robbery and then assault.
First degree robbery and then assault.
What
cool.
Do you think, Law Dictionary?
I'm just checking assault.
Hurry
oh
up.
My god. Right.
Or
is
it battery? Which one is it?
Oh my god. Guys, take it outside, please, for a sec. Right. Mr. Mason, do you want your injuries documented or do you want us to just leave you in peace for the time being?
Would it help your guys' stuff or?
I mean, I'm sure it would.
Oh, okay. Normally, cool. I'm on the other side of this, so.
No, you're all good. Right. Just do me a favor, hold your hands out for me. I'm just gonna run body cam close up of your face and hands. Sure. Oh, okay then. Cool. Thank you very much. Right, do you need medical attention at all? You've been fairly coherent throughout, so I would say you're good, but we have to ask the question.
Yeah, no, I'm good.
Cool. Okie dokes. In that case, I don't think I've got anything further for you. If I do, we'll be in touch, but unless you've got anything further for me, we'll get this gentleman processed back at San DSO and leave you in peace. Is there anything else, or...?
Nope, all good.
Cool. Alright, you have a good night, and yeah, hopefully recover soon. Alright, so we got the assault. Mr. Mason's refusing medical.
Okay, after consulting me, we've decided it's battery, not assault.
I mean, you do have attack points, do you? I can always go and have a little bit of that.
Well, I mean, technically speaking, you could do assault and also battery as two separate charges.
Did they threaten them before they hit them, or did they just hit
yes.
them?
Yes. Well, technically, yes, because they went to rob the, they said, basically, give me all your money, which is basically an intimidation or intent to, intimidate, basically.
I'm just here.
Say again?
You know how much effort it was to try and get him to sit in the back of my car.
You see. I was going to say, I was wondering why your fucking charger looked like it was doing a Carolina squat.
It's a bit... well, they're currently in the head right now, but,
okay.
A bit tight.
Yeah, no, it looks that way.
Well, not my problem. Right.
Eating out of a pot?
Why are you eating bean?
Why not?
Just randomly...
He says, why not? It's delicious.
Yeah, I was about to say, can't people eat down the side of the road, you guys?
Just randomly... where are your shoes?
I don't wear shoes.
No, I'm not... no, I'm not... no, 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 no.
Why are you questioning all of these things? It's just perfectly legal to walk down the road without shoes on and eat beans.
If they cut their feet open in my presence, I then have to try and deal with it.
I mean,
people are cutting their feet open because they don't want to wear shoes.
It's unusual, but it's not illegal.
Oh, I forgot about the bike.
Would you like some hot sauce with your beans?
No.
People have hot sauce with beans.
Do you have mustard?
Yeah, we do.
I'd like that.
Alright.
Got some little packets of mustard that are free if you want those.
That works.
Alright, Mr. Mason, just real quick.
I don't know what that cop's issue was.
Okay.
Beans are good with...
Beans good for the heart. The more you eat, the more you fart.
What?
That conversation was a very entertaining spectator sport.
Yeah, it really was.
Spectate everything, right. We're taller than you?
Including the law. No, I very much doubt it.
No.
6'6".
Hold on, I need to go double check something.
Christ alive. Alright, give me one sec.
User left your channel. User joined your channel.
Hey, Mr. Mason, just before I forgot, actually, that motorcycle, did you get the registration sticker on it?
Am I 6'6 or am I 6'7? Almost accidentally clicked my panic button. Yeah, that'll be a bad decision.
Mr. Mason?
Did you say something?
Yeah, sorry. Just real quick before I forgot. Well, I almost forgot. Did you get the registration sticker for that motorcycle?
I got doused in mustard now.
Yeah.
Alright, what is it for me? And I'll just quickly run it, make sure it's all good.
Alright, 6-9-9, I'll be in our time station 1-10-15.
10-4.
Yeah, basically. Unfortunately. Fair enough. I suggest warming them up. They do taste a lot better.
Yeah, it's my roommate, Garrett Carlson's.
Okay.
I will take your word for it. I don't intend to test that one. You know what they are.
Alright, what do you get? Yeah, if you got the sticker, if you do have the sticker to hand, it'd be appreciated.
Warning: violent, mental health, drugs, theft, robbery, re-offender, parole.
User disconnected from your channel.
Okay. Yep, cool. Okay, dogs, no worries. Right. You take it easy. I'll leave you in peace.
Yep, have a good one. Have it. Never mind, I won't say that word.
Fair enough.
Alright.
You guys have a good one.
You too. Take care. Alright, I'll get the report typed up, and I'll be, okay. 325 by 5.
I'm probably gonna head off and go 42.
Alright, mate, no worries. You take it easy, Sam.
You too. That was certainly interesting. Yeah. You missed our 1080 as well.
Oh, you had a 1080?
We had a 1080 that we were coming down from 68 on Joshua over towards Stab.
Mm-hmm.
And they dipped off through the dirt trail, so I went down Joshua, managed to pull up and get set up. You know that bush right on the corner of Seaview and Joshua?
Mm-hmm.
I got set up behind that and managed to get the perfect spike on him.
Good effort. Well done.
It was great.
Did you get on body cam?
Unfortunately not. I wish I did.
Oh, bro.
I was too focused on pulling the thing back to press the button.
Fair enough.
Yeah, right. I didn't want to spike the Leo units.
Yeah, no, definitely don't do that.
Yeah. Right. It gets expensive. Right,
yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I'm going to get this instant report done.
Andrew.
Yeah. I was going to say, I felt like running the Audi tonight, and then I was like, ooh, track hawk.
Yeah, no, the track hawk is nice. The Audi is really nice too, though.
I was going to run the marked Audi.
I was going to get the competition spot out, but it's still broken.
Yeah, it is, I know. I need to...
Someone left all the lights unplugged last time I went in for maintenance.
Yeah, apparently.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right. I'll be getting them fixed soon, mate, just as a heads up. Right.
Good.
Yeah.
Right. In a bit.
In a bit.
Center 320, go ahead and notify your base tow on lookout. It's going to be one of their vehicles. D20, go ahead and send me one more car. RP is stating the possible suspect who moved the truck is inside the Yellow Jack.
Copy. Who's nearby Yellow Jack, please?
Code 1 response, please.
X-ray 99.
Az, go ahead, bounce to that, please. I'll be tagging along shortly.
Hello. B20 disregard. Looks like it's going to be the driver of the truck.
Granny has it still.
Four.
Yes.
Oh, oh, for God's sake, I'm done. No.
Wait a minute. Is that who I think it is?
Carol Snow.
You're looking for Carol Snow.
Both?
She has my phone.
You know the granny, the one that keeps walking on the freeway.
I saw. Yeah, I saw her here earlier. Actually,
look up for one Carol Snow, also known as the granny, who walks out, who has known to be walking on the freeways.
What are the chances of that?
Hang on. So wait. So what's her involvement here? What's going on?
She's taken his keys, phone, and truck, parked it jacked. So basically, it was hanging off the sand over there.
Right.
And then left.
Okay. Right, okay. Also,
consent.
Sorry to ask, but who's this? And why are they wearing a sheriff jacket?
That's up to Frost, I think. I don't know.
I was about to say, yeah, talk to Frost, because apparently Frost knows her pretty well. My guess is she called 911 because she was out.
She has a spider on her foot, that's all I know.
Alright. Hey, ma'am, you got a spider on your foot?
Oh, Jesus.
Alright.
But anyway, I saw her as soon as I pulled into the parking lot, so I'm guessing she called 911.
Okay, right.
So I would say, see if she can give us a person description. Initially, what I was going to say, but now we know who to look for.
Yeah. All right. Right, ma'am.
Carol Snow. What are the chances?
Okay. Right. Ma'am, just real quick, I'm going to ask you either get home, get a different jacket on, or either ask your dad to pick you up, just simply because I appreciate it's not the active uniform going at the moment, but because it has official Blaine County patches on it, I technically
you
can't allow you
for
yeah
impersonate them, even if it's been given to you.
Yeah, I get it, your dad gave it to you, but you shouldn't have really given it to you if, like, you're out walking about in the public eye with it, I'm afraid. Right.
Yeah, that's true.
It's not raining enough.
Yeah, it's not raining anymore.
I'm wearing a t-shirt.
Alright. I ain't gonna chase it up for now, but just in the future. I don't wanna catch you out wearing it in the future, please.
It's right. Like a mini Ava.
Yeah, appreciate that. Right.
I don't want to press anything on Granny.
Okay. Where do you know whereabouts she is at the moment?
She put me in timeout.
Excuse me?
You don't argue with Granny.
Right, I don't care what she's done to you. Do you know where her whereabouts are right now?
No.
Right.
Do you want to start a bolo out just in case, Will?
Yeah, please. Can you put it out for me, Shira, and I'll let everyone know?
I can just start it in CAD.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. You should be able to start one in CAD.
Okay. Carol Snow, correct?
Yes, correct.
Okay, yeah, I thought so.
Damn, ouch.
Okay, witnessed a random muscle spasm.
God
again.
Damn it. I guess I just have a really punchable face tonight. Shit.
Don't tempt me.
Try me.
Oh, okay. Let's see how it is.
Okay, I'm gonna step over here.
No, I'm not gonna have a muscle spasm. I can't. My arms are crossed.
Try me.
I have a taser next to my hand.
Yeah, even still. Right.
Taser system.
Right, let's try and get an AP. Let's get this APB out and then go from there, guys. Just keep your eyes peeled.
Yeah. I'll get it started if... if anybody wants to, like, take statements from either of these two, I guess. So I'll get the bolo started.
Statement's already been taken, I thought.
No, because you so far are well more behaved than Avis. You would have probably stabbed someone by now.
Yeah, right?
And that's coming from...
I'll be back.
All broken the law. I don't mean, like, literally, she would have stabbed, like, physically stabbed someone. All, you know, broken the law in some other way. Ava's just stupid. Have a good one, G.
Yeah.
Charlie 1, all units, for information only at this time, it's going to be an APB bolo put out on a Carol Snow. All units, just keep your eyes out. She is known to be a vulnerable person, also suffering from early onset dementia.
Director.
Yeah, what's up? Sorry, too. Yeah, what's up, Jay?
I have a bad hunch.
Right.
The highway?
I really hope not.
No, but... I don't know which way she went when she left here, so...
Okay. No worries, we'll keep an eye out, mate.
And I know she's been known to walk on the highway before, so...
Gee, you shouting.
Hmm.
Also, shield, it's the sky.
Oh, excuse me?
You said what's up?
Okay. Alright. Right, I'm gonna go change. I'm gonna go check the highway.
That's what I was about to do, goddammit.
I should not know we'll be coming.
Incoming 911.
Charlie 1, can I have someone en route to that, please? I'm just scanning northbound Route 13, see if she's come down this way.
Thanks for not an item route.
320 all units be advised. Bolo for Carol Snow is now active. Report number 3916. Details on your screens.
Happy days, sure.
Let 301 of them to locate Carol Snow.
410, I'll be en route to the latest 911 as well.
Charlie 1 up to Marmarker Golf has been searched. No contact, now doing southbound 13.
Center 320, is more assistance needed on that?
Yeah, if you want to come this way, Shira, by all means. She's been last seen in the area of the Davis Court, so if you can search that area, not necessarily just 13, Mike.
10-4, I'm nearby. ET is less than 1.
Good copy. Charlie 1, I'm going to push further south on 13 to the 13-15 split. I'll head back up from there.
320, I'm going to go further north and see if I can locate.
10-4.
Thanks for that, 9-Charlie 1.
Go ahead.
Can we get a bird up?
Yes, yes, if you need, if you want to, mate, then go for it, Az.
Center 320 priority.
Send it.
Believe I might have possible eyes on individual going to be walking along the railroad tracks alongside 13. Looks like it's going to be right across from postal 3050. I need to get closer to see if I can confirm ID. Standby.
Charlie 1 to 499, standby on that aviation activation for now.
Level.
Charlie 1, I'm in the area. I'm going to attempt to locate.
Actually, at 1 PID. It's them.
Yeah, Charlie 1, 499, stand down on aviation.
Stand down.
320, 481. Is this the suspect?
A firm.
10-4, 320, all units. Confirmed ID on individual Carol Snow.
10-4, let's get into the back of a vehicle, get her to safety, please. If someone can let Matt Gervais know we've located her.
Excellent advice. Current train line along 13 are shut down. As ADOT is aware of incident.
Received.
Nine, can you come down here and search her, please? Make sure she doesn't have any weapons on her.
Miss, we're going to take you to Springles. Just do me a favor. Do you have anything on this compartment, Mr. Mill Stab, mate? We know where Sprinkles is, alright? We're gonna take the Sprinkles, but I just need to look over you, alright?
Careful,
yeah, I know, I'm not gonna hurt you, alright? If you need to, lean up against the Highway Patrol vehicle.
What's that, Kev, just do me a favor, just back it up a touch, just in case there are any trains that come through, mate.
Yeah.
Cheers, mate.
The car that's behind you.
Oh, no, Gary, I can't drive.
No, lean up against it.
But, what?
Grim, are the keys still in your truck?
I have no idea. Yes, they should be.
Wouldn't be, but...
Cool.
I don't know why. Why?
No.
Okay.
Great. I'm not gonna hurt your hip, alright? I'm also gonna make sure that if there's anything I can do to make your hip feel better.
Honestly, well, I'm just gonna stay in the car until we're gonna put her in mine.
She's yes, we are. Do you have a cage?
Yes, he does.
She has nothing on her.
Alright, well, someone sit her in the back seat of that car then. And tracks.
Yeah, it's on lock, guys.
Right, do you want to just come sit in the back of this car for us? This guy is going to take you to Sprinkled. You said you were looking for Sprinkled. You currently have to get back to the car and we're going to get you out of here.
Anyway. X-ray 1, all units clear the tracks. Center 320, individual is secure. Gonna be clearing the tracks.
Apparently, this worker has been dead for like 10 years.
Yeah, that sounds about right. Alright, give me a second. I'm going to call G Towing and let them know we found her.
Alrighty. Am I taking her back to Sandy SO?
Yeah, please, mate.
Alright, not a problem.
Hey, Will.
One sec, I need to contact G Towing.
Yeah, the granny
oh
has his phone.
Oh, you're joking.
Center 320-1070,
right.
San Diego.
Okay.
SO DOT knows the tracks are clear.
Me and Tommy will go, me and Lieutenant will go find him. We'll send him out towards SO.
Okay.
DOT knows that the track's clear, so that's all good.
Cool. Alright, I'm gonna see if I can find another contact number for G-Towing.
Alrighty.
Extra not known, Black Connect.
Jolly one, when we get Miss Snow back to BSSO custody, can we, number one, seize any items she has on her person, including the mobile phone, and also could we get the force medical staff to do a psych eval on her, please, and get in contact with Sandy Med regarding any sort of medications she may have.
The fact that we found her and she was going to San Diego, so...
320, can I possibly have somebody meet me at SO just to help her?
Huh?
She's claiming I've apparently kidnapped her.
Well, two mainly...
410 and 499, if you can assist with that, please. 410, the supervisor. 499 is a female deputy, please.
Yeah.
410.
Alright, have we got... Is her phone still on her, or is it with you, Frost?
Copy,
I was the one who searched her.
Fucking hell, right.
In my car,
can you make your way down to San Diego, please,
you,
mate?
You just sent the person who searched her to there.
Yeah. Give me one sec. Matt.
Yeah.
Get yourself down to San Diego, please.
That's what I was. Frost was just telling me.
No, just yeah, just get down there, mate. We'll get your phone back to you.
Tara, come over here if you want to talk. I'm just getting out of the way. Also, how are you driving if she has you? You could end up carpooling here, Shield.
Yeah. Why is your truck smoking?
Oh. Looks like I blew a radiator hose.
Damn.
Right, can you secure it for now?
Yep.
Cool. Alright, I'll take you.
Yeah. Shouldn't worry about the engine though.
Alright, have you got anything on your person I need to be aware of, mate? Because you will be getting searched before you go in my vehicle.
Nope, not even a knife.
Cool, just step in front of my patrol car for me.
Yeah, I'm...
Oh, okay then. Cool. Alright, appreciate it. Right, just you can hop in the front seat if you want.
Center 320, we have Miss Snow secure in San Diego.
I'll have to call statewide.
That's just super advised. I'm bringing Matt Gervais to BCSO Sandy Station now.
Maybe I should carry a company phone too.
Yeah, ideally.
Well, it's going to be in the LSST Highway Patrol section of San Diego.
Yeah, be advised, Matt Gervais is without a vehicle at this time. His vehicle's currently been disabled at YJI.
Oh, it's a red light. Even notice that, I thought it was green.
Does he need a left, or is he getting a tug?
Be advised, I'm currently giving him a ride to SO now. Someone can meet him at the front desk, please, because we're arriving now.
10-4.
Is her daughter or granddaughter coming?
I'm sorry, say that again.
Is your granddaughter coming to pick her up?
I don't know yet. Alright, let's get your phone back first and then we'll go from there.
And my wallet.
And your wallet, right, okay.
Oh, hi, Yuri. I haven't seen you. Okay.
I'm gonna go back tonight.
Yeah, hold on,
right,
Az.
Come with me, Rick. Right. Let's go. I'm bailing you out. I'm bailing you out. It's okay. Granny will cover your bail.
Granny!
Granny, it's the other way around.
Okay.
Yeah,
it's over here? Okay, I'll pay his bail over here.
No, this is the scenario's the other way around.
Alright.
Who's bailing you out?
Hey, have either one of the deputies called her granddaughter.
She has a granddaughter.
Katie Gervais.
Must name tonight.
She's dead.
No.
Yes, dearie, she died years ago.
Right. Wallet.
Are you talking about
phone? Whoa. Wallet, phone. Have you got those? Where are they?
I found nothing on her when I searched her, so.
Fuck's sakes. Alright, so your wallet and your phone are out there somewhere, Matt.
Yeah, a good place to keep those is always keep them in your vehicle.
Alright.
Before she's hidden them somewhere in your truck.
Yeah.
I'm gonna say
Charlie 1 X-ray 4821.
Send.
You still 97 at YJI?
I'm still 23 at YJI, yes.
Yeah, I realised as soon as I said it. Do me a favour, we're going to bring Matt back to search the truck. Apparently, the wallet and phone may actually still be in the truck.
Can you ask him if it's unlocked and I'll see if it's there right now?
It's not, he locked it before we left.
Cover.
Right.
Fair warning. If I do get a bird up to try and search for a phone and all that, it's going to be a limited search with thermals.
Yeah.
Yeah, right?
Right. Matt, I'll take you back. Is there anything we want to be doing about Miss Snow here, or...?
I call her granddaughter.
Okay.
Thinking she... on her emergency contact.
Alright, Shearer and Az, if you can arrange her granddaughter to pick her up, please. And then, once you've done that, get back out there as well, please.
No, Granny, no, you got to stay in there.
Granny, you gotta stay in the, you gotta stay in that room.
Stay with Auntie Azrael.
Yeah,
stay with Auntie Az.
Grim.
What is cookies.
She looks like something smacked her face.
It probably did.
Yeah.
She did not just say that.
Granny, just come back inside.
Granny,
okay.
I'll come
potty.
And visit there, alright?
I need to go to the potty.
Alright. Show her to the loos, please.
I don't know what...
Yeah, you'll find her.
Alright, Grant, let's go on an adventure to find the toilets.
Sheesh.
This is why I retired out of that industry. This industry.
Yeah, right.
I was a sheriff deputy for a bit after I got out, and I'm like, no.
Yeah, it's been a while.
I'm not even... Yeah, I just want to go home and... not work?
Something like that.
Oh. Like I told... Staff Sergeant Frost, if I ever get that bad... Or I hope I don't ever get that bad.
Why is that?
As bad as Granny?
Mm.
Forgetful.
Well, there is that.
You know, I like... remember...
220, try one direct.
You know, I don't want to be a...
Go ahead.
Looks like the emergency contact for Carlton is going to be a Samantha Gervais. Pretty sure we've had dealings with her before. Do we know a possible phone number for her by chance? I'm not seeing anything in the system.
Stand by. Hey, Matt. Do you, do you know a Sam Gervais?
My sister.
Right. Apparently she's noted down as the contact number for Granny.
Well, that's her granddaughter's wife, so...
Right. Well, if you can get in contact with her at some point to go pick Granny up, that'll be appreciated, mate.
Yeah, once I find my phone.
Yeah.
Why do I have a feeling we've just had a major security breach at Sandy SO?
What do you mean?
Well, someone just asked for a phone number, so I'm only assuming that she ended up walking off.
Hey, can one of you throw me into my truck?
Yeah, I got you. No.
Think... Maybe?
Apparently not.
Alright, well, we'll do this way.
Yes, way too tired.
Correct.
Aye.
Terra just signed weird old lady.
Oh, what person we've been dealing with? Yes.
Yeah.
Yep, definitely weird old lady.
Yeah, she has a tendency to do that with everyone. The last time she tried it with me, though, I put cuffs on her and put her in the back of a car, so she doesn't try it with me anymore.
Yeah.
She's, like, I don't know, deaf, dementia, a lot of things, I don't know. She has a lot of things going on. All of the above. She just has all of them.
Yeah.
Huh? What? What are you handing me? What?
Hi, Derek. I got him.
I can, I was just wondering. Huh?
No, I think she's saying Carol Snow couldn't read her or understand her sign language. Alright, yeah. You got your stuff back.
Yeah.
That's good. That's,
you know what, Tara, you're right, you win. Okay.
Right, who's the legal guardian for Carol Snow then? Is it your sister, Matt?
I believe it's my sister and her wife.
Right, is Carol been signed on for any care homes or anything like that?
I believe she is in a nursing home.
Do you know which one?
Not offhand.
Okay, well, if it happens in the future, we'll probably be having to look at taking legal action against either Sam and or her wife, or the care home, so.
I have my tablet here. Sam Gervais is down as an emergency contact.
Yeah, that's what Shira said.
She also has a curfew flag, by the way.
Is the curfew stated at all?
Not in the additional notes.
Right, okay.
We have a bolt. Oh, that's just after being put out, that bolo can be closed, I guess. There's a recent report.
Okay, well, I'm gonna go back 10-8, but yeah. We'll see what comes of this.
Are you good?
Situation.
Your voice box was cutting in and out there, Director. Are you good?
Tired, mate. Tired.
Okay.
Yeah. No. I'll go back tonight. But yeah, we'll see what happens with this situation. But if it keeps happening, because a pattern's developing now, then we may have to start taking legal action against either the care home and/or Sam and/or her wife. Sorry.
The issue is, Sheil. We said that last time we brought her off of a highway. She's now migrated onto a more dangerous means of transportation called train tracks.
Yeah, I know. That's why I'm saying if it happens again, it's like, that's it.
How many more chances are we going to be giving them?
Because, technically speaking, there is a difference between trespassing on a highway and trespassing on train tracks. As such, because the element of danger is different, albeit similar. But because the jurisdiction is technically separate, then yeah, we kind of have to go with that. But now that, technically speaking, now the only other place she could trespass is Chilliad. If she is found on the highways or train tracks or anything like that, then we can take her into custody next time for trespass and or, like, you know, get her signed off on a 5150 indefinitely if needed. So yeah, I'll leave it at that.
Yep.
Right, I'm gonna head out, so you guys stay safe. Hopefully your truck gets fixed soon, Matt. Frost, Terra, take it easy. Also, actually, Frost, as a side note, I don't want to be seeing Tara wearing anything to do with any official Blaine County stuff, Blaine County Sheriff stuff, in public. at home or, you know, at a friend's is fine, but hello? not in the public place. Because it I still mean, comes to...
Yeah.
I get it, the uniform is outdated, but it technically still comes under impersonation, I'm afraid. Unless there's prior authorization from the sheriff himself.
Okay. I was just under assumption that as long as it didn't have any identifiers on it.
Yep.
Technically, because it's got the patches on the sleeves, on the shoulder part of the sleeves,
right.
It's technically identifying as BCSO. Talk to the sheriff about it, because if you ask the sheriff about a incident he had where there were you know, the whole movie or filming scene, yeah, it's similar sort of situation as to that, mate. Not saying it's a bollocking, just as a heads up, because it is still a thing, unfortunately. But certainly in this instance, it's cold night. I get it. I'm not going to be a dick about it, but yeah. Anyways, like I said, yeah, you guys stay safe, stay warm, everything like that, and I'll catch you guys out there.
Yep.
All right, take care, guys.
Have a
safe night. You too. The one I'll be code for tonight.
B20 Charlie 1, just to give you a status update. I've contacted Samantha Gervais. She's on her way to pick her up.
That's received. Good work, Cheryl.
To find Sunday airfield outbound search. Saturday 20 update. So far, Route 68 west of Zancudo is going to be clear at this time. No visual and suspect vehicle.
What's that? That's ahead of us. Oh, it's a hot dog stand. Never mind.
X-ray 1, got the vehicle. Postal 1000, it's going to be at the 24/7 Rocket Diner area.
God damn it.
P20 in route, P2 is that bad.
Charlie 1, same traffic.
Yeah,
let's see soon. Martin, I'll be in route in an unmarked interceptor radio vehicle.
I doubt it's going to be a pursuit, but...
ET is about less than 3.
Eagle 2, 10-9, your radio with traffic.
guys, I've got the vehicle heading into Colita right now. On the way to gas station.
Eagle 2, location update.
AD1, they're still inside the wrong gas station. I need an update on those marked units.
220, I'm on Route 1 now, coming up to Braddock Pass. Should be ETA with you just about a minute.
Charlie 1, I'll be 23. Yes, yes, I thought you would have already done it, but go ahead. Okay.
I didn't do it because I'm not a marked unit.
Confirm, postal 1000.
That's good.
Negative, wrong gas station in Toledo, 1012.
Excuse me, man.
Alright, 10-4. Just about less than a mile away.
Excuse me, ma'am.
What do you want?
I'm Director Will Shields, San Andreas Department of Public Safety. Okay, just to let you know, this interaction has been audio and video recorded through body cam and equipment to me and my colleagues' vehicles. The reason we stopped you is because there's been a vehicle mentioned in the description that's possibly been involved in a hit and run of a, is it a push cycle, guys, or a motorcycle? Yeah. Push bike.
I didn't hit anything. You can check my vehicle for damage. I haven't hit anything.
Okay, but I appreciate that. Have you got a dash cam fit to the vehicle at all?
Yes, I do.
Okay, do you mind if we check that?
Yes, I mind. What is this about? I didn't hit anything.
Well, we've had a report that the vehicle matching your description has hit something, so...
Okay, and why are there four cars here for something if I supposedly hit one thing?
You should go to nail school.
Well, that's to ensure that you don't run off. Because something like a hit and run, usually the people will run.
There was no hit and run.
Okay, well, can I check your dash cam to quantify that then?
Look at my vehicle, there's no damage.
Yeah,
I
know.
Didn't hit anything.
I know, but between the time you've hit it and now, you could have had it repaired or resprayed or anything, whereas the dash camera's not going to lie, is it?
It's also covered in dirt, so I couldn't get it repaired or painted up, and I've been going from store to store getting food for the homeless camp over there, so
okay.
No, I haven't had time to do that.
Okay, well, I appreciate that, but still, the one thing that's gonna prove all innocence, ma'am, is literally your dash cam, if you're willing to allow us to check it.
I haven't hit anything.
Okay.
Ma'am, we have CCTV footage from the 24/7 in Sandy showing your vehicle hitting a bicycle.
I didn't hit anything.
Alright, well, are we okay?
Well,
right.
We have camera footage of your vehicle doing it.
Yeah. Ma'am, last time I'm gonna ask is if we can check your dash cam.
I need to get into my vehicle to pull it up to show you. Can I do that?
Yeah, that's absolutely fine.
Okay, I can't just magically show it to you without getting it.
Okay.
I don't know why the guy who harassed me last time is back at me.
User disconnected from your channel.
Okay, yeah, I see no bike here.
10-5, good night.
Like when I pull up, yeah, there's the bike there, but when I pull off, I don't see that it's getting hit.
Okay, do you mind if I check it for myself? Cool, thank you. Right, so from what I can see there, it doesn't show you hitting the bike, but also it doesn't necessarily clear you because it's out of frame. As Staff Sergeant Frost has already explained, we do actually have footage of you making contact with the bike.
I don't listen to him because he's already harassed me in the past, so...
Okay, that's absolutely fine, I appreciate that. Right. Do you think there's any possible way you could have even just slightly nudged it or something like that?
If I hit it, I would have stopped and talked to the person who owned it.
Okay.
That's
not an issue. Alright, just sit tight for me and I'll be back with you, man.
It's not like I can afford to pay for the damages, if there were any.
Right,
any way that you could do a momentarily pit stop landing for a phone call?
What? What the? What? Okay, right.
I'm clearing it up for you, but I can't do that if she's flying a helicopter.
Nah, fair enough. I guess in that guy's Play-Doh. Right. Do we think that there's...
As far as I saw, that bike wasn't nudged, it was mutilated.
Right, okay, it was, and it's gone being run completely over.
That's what I noticed. Unless my quick glance was wrong, but
God knows.
I'm not sure. I didn't pay much attention to it. I only looked at it briefly when
I'll be real.
Move the bike off the road,
mate. A Rolls Royce Wraith versus a push bike. Even if you ran completely over it, I doubt you're gonna notice. Don't notice it much.
Also,
you
see this regard. I haven't put it obstacles in the way.
What did they just say?
There's obstacles in the way of the landing zone at Pluto.
Of course there is.
AKA the floodlights.
Yeah.
We're landing on the beach for this angle.
Thank fuck.
Amazing.
Okay. Her. She has a full helicopter crew in there and she's SRT trained. I don't give a shit.
Right, okay. Look, point being is that if she's run over the bike, I would say she's clearly done it. Like, I would say she's probably done it by accident. But even still, it doesn't necessarily make it correct. I'd say in order to resolve this, we can go with... We can go with dropping the hit and run charges if they pay for the repair of the bike or something like that. Because either way, they've hit what appears to be a static object, and that is on them, insurance-wise.
Give me a second. Does that really explain that... the verbal abuse that she gave the person?
What, she actually had a verbal altercation with the person?
I believe so.
Right, okay. So that, at that point, she... Yeah, okay. Okay, hey, that changes things.
I'm gonna need a couple of things from you. I remember you saying something in the about the vehicle hitting the bike, yes? Did it come to your Did it look like the vehicle ran it completely over, or did it just hit it, or did it like, or would it have, I don't know, maybe just knocked it over? From the information you got from your victim and your CCTV. His, and then run it partly over. Do you still have the copy of it there? Can you send it to me?
Right, I'll just update our customer here.
Okay. Another thing. Just to confirm.
Alright, ma'am. So at the minute, we're just in contact with one of the deputies that checked the CCTV footage of the incident. Okay. Just clarifying a few things before we go over it. Can I just confirm with you, did you actually talk to the person that owned the bicycle? At the 24/7.
I talked to some brat outside of it that was disrespectful and mouthy, but I don't know who owns the bike.
Okay, so from what it appears, that...
I have no way of knowing who owns it.
That's fine. I'm not necessarily too worried about that. But all I'm saying is that from what it's looking like, there is an element that basically you have hit the bike, but from what it looks like, you've hit it unknowingly. Depending on how we go down with this, because it would technically depend on the owner as well. Ultimately, we can give them the option of if they want to press charges or not. If they want to press charges, we'll have to go ahead with a hit and run charge.
So they can press charges on me because they put their bike in the road.
Bear with me.
And I not knowingly hit it.
Yeah,
apparently.
Just bear with me.
Okay, that's on them.
Well, no, it's not.
If they put it in the road, yes, it is on them.
No, I mean, because if that bike's been parked, you've hit a parked object, okay, or you've hit a hazard in the road, that is on you, I'm afraid. But regardless of that, the second option we can go with is if they don't want to press charges, or if we can get them basically, if we can ask you to pay for the damage done to the bike, which
yeah,
then...
I already said I would pay for it.
Yeah. Okay, so if you're happy with that, then we can clarify that.
If I damaged it, then yes, I will pay for it. I've already said that.
Okay. No, that's fine. I just wanted to clear it with you, make sure. But yeah. All right. Sit tight, we'll be with you. Right. Frost making another phone call. All right, one second. All right, Frost. Frost? Mike, right, real quick.
I'm trying to get a couple of finalized things sorted, but well.
Right. Do we still have contact with the person whose bike has been hit?
I've just requested it from Az.
Okay, happy days.
I was going to get her to do it, but she's currently getting a fan base for a helicopter down on the beach, so I just said to send it.
Right. Okay.
Was that traffic for 81?
I didn't hear what she said.
She's just saying, going back airborne.
Hey, for apologies.
Alright.
Give me a second to check my emails, because I think I might have been sent everything. Hang on.
Okay, no worries, mate. Alright, I'm going to let Frost handle this, because he seems to be taking a head on it. Yes.
Wow, this is
Director.
Now can be considered harassment at this point.
Director.
Yeah, what's up, Frost?
Got the footage.
Cool, happy. Let's have a look.
Okay. Blue and pink Rolls Royce.
Check.
Hang on, let me just pull it up here properly because I can't properly see it. Hang on. Okay. Pink and blue vehicle pulls up.
woman gets out, buys stuff, then leaves, talks to the person outside, then gets in her car and leaves. While leaving, she hits, looks like she hits the bike and runs part of it over. So.
Right, okay. So she's definitely run it over then. Okay. Well.
Yeah.
The owner of this Rolls Royce, has said that, you know, she is happy to pay for any damages she may have done.
Okay.
So if we get in contact with the original reporting party, mm-hmm. we'll give them the option of whether they want to press charges or.
Negative, you're good.
We'll give them the option whether they want to press charges or just have the payment for the damage done and then
yeah.
proceed from there.
I'll try it.
Okay, cool. Right. Okay, man. We're gonna get. We're gonna try and get in contact with the reporting party, whose bike you may have hit, and then, if they're happy to, we'll just go with settling this through payment for damages rather than pressing charges. Okay.
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay.
I just want to know why it happens to be that officer that's always around me.
Luck of the draw. Couldn't tell you, I'm afraid. Alright. Bear with us, man. We'll get this wrapped up fairly soon for you.
Well, hopefully, because I gotta get this food away.
I understand.
Hello, is this Althea? How's it going? It's Staff Sergeant Frost. Really quick, I'd just like to confirm with you.
Hey Kev, could you do me a favor?
Yep.
Can you do me a favor? Just take Shearer's. LSSD cruise around the corner and fleet it for me.
Yeah.
Cheers, mate. What's up, Frost?
Okay, so...
That's hilarious!
You had an argument, she was calling you names, like riffraff and all that. Just general stuff. Okay. And you asked her to stop Camley, and you went back and forth Camley about it?
Oh, can I actually hear Thorn on his phone? That's pretty cool.
Until she was basically screaming at you, I take it. Okay. So it built up to a point where she started shouting at you, or what seemed like shouting at you. Okay, cool. Also, just to let you know, Shield, will I inform her about this? About the agreement that the female here wants to do?
Yes, that's fine.
The female here who ran over your bike says she is happy to pay for any damages done to your bike that she may have caused. Okay. Yeah, okay. Yeah, so... Okay, so you're happy with her paying for the damages? Okay. Just hang on a second, Althea. Director, do you have any other comments, questions, concerns before I hang up the phone?
No.
Okay, cool. All right, Althea, appreciate it. Thank you very much. Stay safe now.
Cool.
Okay, yeah, no, they had a... She came out of the store and started saying something along the lines of all the young riffraff out here on the streets and all this.
Yeah, she seems to generally have a negative view about the younger people, but yeah,
she's those type. Also, just to clear up, the harassment from that she's claiming that I'm doing is her trying to walk away from me and Cadet Parker when we were trying to do an investigation about her calling us down there for threats on her life.
Right. Okay.
And I kept saying that she wasn't allowed leave and that she was detained, and you will unfortunately have to wait until my partner is done investigating before you can leave.
Gotcha. Okay.
And then she just asked for a supervisor, so I just called G down there, captain down there, sort of. So
yeah, no worries.
That's
cool.
That's what she's referencing there, but as for this whole altercation thing, I'll leave that up to you on what you want to do. Althea is more than happy to accept the offer of paying for the damages onto her bicycle.
Okay. Right. Let's get... So if Althea gets an invoice from whichever shop she takes it to get it repaired, she should send the invoice to BCSO. BCSO then can forward it on to Miss Campbell, her. Okay.
As long as we can get an email address for her.
Yeah, happy days. Okay, no worries. I'll get that sorted.
Yep.
All right, is it Miss Campbell or Mrs. Campbell?
Miss Campbell.
Miss Campbell. Okay, Miss Campbell. So, the complainant's saying they're happy for this to be this issue to be resolved civilly, so through payment of the damages. What we'll do, we'll let you go on your way now, but just before we do, the way we're going to proceed with this is... the complainant is going to get a invoice from whichever shop she's choosing to do the repairs. She will send the invoice to BCSO. BCSO will then email you the invoice, and obviously then if you can make a check payable to the complainant, that'll be appreciated, but details will all be discussed at a later date.
As long as the price they say is actual the price and not some bullshit, I want a new $1 million bike.
Yeah, no, exactly. Well, that sort of stuff will be included in the invoice. And on top of which, BCSO will also say, well, hang on, this isn't charged for, like, say, a new bike wheel or something like that, depending on the damages of what we've observed, you know. So we'll also be clued in on that, so.
Well, can I see the CCTV footage, see what actually was hit? Because
yeah.
I literally heard or felt nothing, so.
Okay, no, that's,
I'm guessing it was
that's
just
fine.
Fire.
Yeah. Frost.
Yes.
Can you show Miss Campbell the CCTV from your tablet, please? Yeah, Miss Campbell, if you'd like to come over.
Four cops and a heli for a frickin' tire. Nice. This is dumb.
Alright. Okay, I think we're safe to wrap up here. Alright, ma'am, we're gonna wrap up here. Do you have any other questions, comments, concerns before we go?
Nope, just... let me know whatever the price is whenever they get it.
Yeah, no worries. We'll be in touch on, I think they're going to send you an email. We've got all your details on CAD, so we can give you details through that, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Cool. All right, have a good day.
Will do.
Charlie will not be code for tonight.
81 time.
I think my charge is better. My charger is better. Not sure. I get the point.
Damn. That's rude, sir.
Real quick, what's she saying about this harassment thing, because you were saying it earlier about, what was it? You and so, Parker?
Okay, so, for starters, just so you know, this was already resolved, okay?
And yep.
This is going to be very entertaining, just like this one was. So, she called us, okay? She called 911.
It's all about the man spread. I'm not gonna lie, I've only just combined that and I'm fucking loving it. I don't even care.
That person can wait. My phone's ringing, they can wait. So, they called us because they, quote-unquote, thought someone who was using sign language was them throwing gang signs and threatening them, right? Bear in mind, right. This was Terra, mm-hmm. by the way.
Mm-hmm.
So,
was
you can imagine how well that
anyways.
Was going.
Yeah.
Terra is actually... Is death?
Death. Mute.
She just... Yeah.
That's it.
So that was very entertaining in itself, just hearing that portion of it. So, after, you know, I'm obviously Parker is doing her own investigation. I'm only, like, advising, because I'm trying to allow Parker to do as much of it as possible so she can kind of get the ropes again. Obviously answering any questions mm-hmm. and concerns that she has. Now, I'm now informing Ms. Campbell about, the fact that, you know, some people use this thing called sign language, that I explained all that, and then she said, okay, you're dismissed, and then starts walking towards her car. I go, hang on a second, you're not allowed to go anywhere, and you don't dismiss us, that's not how this works. You called us down here, we're conducting investigation, unfortunately, you will have to wait until my partner is done with the investigation before you can leave. That was my professional response, and then she just kept going. So then I just kept saying the same thing until I said, look, you can't dismiss us, okay? You have to sit here until you are told you are free to leave by my partner. I do not know if she has done her investigation or not. And then she was like, I want a supervisor. So I just went, okay, I would love to get my supervisor down here. So I just called Watch Command, which
amazing.
Was the captain at the time. So, captain came down, stepped aside, already claiming that I was harassing, and came over and interrupted me explaining the situation to the captain and all this, and yeah. And is clearly still claiming it as me harassing her, and she said that she
awesome.
Doesn't want me anywhere near her ever again and all that. To be honest with you...
Okay.
If she doesn't want me near her, that's fine, but at that point, she can't blame me if she's shot and she doesn't want me treating her and she unfortunately suffers worse injuries.
Yeah, no, that's fair enough.
Yellowjack tried to make the same threat. I just turned around and just said, look, I will show up here if there is an emergency call here and there is nothing you can do to stop that because it's called me doing my job.
Yeah, no, exactly.
So, yeah. That's what that's about.
Fair enough. Yeah, I don't think she quite understands that when it's a hit and run, irrespective of whether it's, you know, a bike tire or anything, the fact that her plate wasn't pinging cameras as well is kind of a little bit sus. Who put the
something
who put
tells
this AMPR camera on it?
I knew it was a hit and run.
Yeah, who put the AMPR info in?
Yeah, apparently Grimm did, but I have a feeling they may have entered it incorrectly.
Yeah.
So, by right, I should have asked them how they did it, and then I should have fixed the issue if there was an issue, and that's on me, because I was on scene. I get that, but at the same time, I was also trying to make sure Althea wasn't injured as well, because Grimm couldn't. So it's kind of one of those things of, I would have done it if I wasn't busy doing something else.
Nah, I gotcha. Mate, just a quick one, actually, on mentioning RTO, though. Make sure you are calling out. Make sure in the future.
I was going to answer you the first time. I was getting out of my truck when you started asking the second time.
What
I can't
in relation
to my radio and getting out of my truck at the same time?
Right. No, I'll be honest, mate. I've noticed this happen more than once. Don't worry. I know Hudson does at the same time, but I have chats with Hudson also on a separate occasion with it. So, just please, even if you are. What, like, 'cause what I'll do is, if I'm not going to technically respond to the call, but I just want to be in the area, I'll just say, like, Charlie 1, I'll be in the area just in case you need a backup or something like that. Just because, yeah, the RTO side of things is actually very important, mate. So, yeah. But no, other than that, mate, that's all I really got to say on it. You all good? Cool. All right, mate. Right. I'm probably going to mill about for an extra probably half hour or so, and then I'll probably call it soon. But yeah, I'll see you guys back out there.
You're
welcome. All right.
If you want to go live, look at your emails.
All right, mate. No worries. I will do. Cool. All right. In a bit of frost. Lotus curve.
Incoming 911.
Charlie 1, who have I got closest to 3002, please?
New dispatch, 3002, East Joshua Road, 3002.
Yeah, take it, please. You're the closest unit. I'll assist. I'm responding from Mark Roska.
Copy. I'm gonna grab a different truck to accommodate the call I want to for the unit together.
Copy, have a good night, Tommy.
User disconnected from your channel.
You put me on the rock in the rocky area of the national park.
That's for safe.
Extra 99, can you have your route to this call with me, please? I already have the top of the route with the vehicle you're in.
Jesus. Oh crap, we wanted Route 68 Approach Road. I'll just take a left here.
Be advised, suspect is victim is going to be PID'd as Mr. Snarl. Stand by.
Tell the one, I've got eyes on you. I'm gonna route round the tracks.
He's after falling back down the rock on my side.
Snow, buddy, please talk to me. Just come on.
I don't know, I'm just out of curiosity. What is Mr. Snow's actual name?
Be advised, I don't think anyone knows.
Whoa, this charger's acceleration factor is twitchy. Frost, you hold the northeast corner. Az, hold a south corner. I'll hold the northwest corner.
He's on the rock. I'm looking at him.
Carpe. I'll be out on foot. God damn it. There we go. As he's running towards you, mate. Snarl, stop running about, buddy. Mate, stop there for a sec, please. Hello. Mate, can you stop ignoring us, please? Gentlemen, we got medics towards, please.
X-ray 1, I'm here.
Oh, Roger, you go and tank medic.
A-firm, that's the truck I was grabbing.
We just want to make sure okay,
turn
right?
4.
No, you haven't done anything wrong, so make sure you're okay, okay? Not in trouble. We just want to make sure you're alright. Alright?
Frost, just hold what you got, where you are, please. We've got Az engaging with them at the minute.
What's
going on? What's going on, David? No, what's happened? Like, why are you hurt, alright? I just want to make sure you're okay. You're obviously hurt, mate. Is that not yours? David, be honest with me, is that your blood or is that someone else's?
Warning, mental health, drugs, or evade, medical concern, theft, curfew, poaching.
Buddy, you're not in trouble. We just want to make sure everything's alright with you. What's going on? Would you sit down so we can have a look over you? I still want to have you sit down and look over you just to make sure, right? You better be safe than sorry. I know you're saying you're not hurt, but I'd still rather make sure. Tell me what happened. Would you be able to tell me what happened, David?
She's dead.
David, please. Please don't walk away, buddy. What's happened? Who's dead?
Yes, I know. Like, the blood on him isn't related to any injuries he has. The only thing I can identify is a bullet graze to his right side. The other blood on him is dried. He's advising that someone is dead.
So I want to be advised, he does have a marker for poaching, but that's the only other thing I can think of. It might be animal blood.
That's because he hunts the animals himself.
Is it a person or
yeah,
an
well that makes sense.
Weapon is what I'm talking about.
Yeah, that makes sense then.
Yeah.
What's the last name?
What was his... Do we know his name?
David Cairn.
Oh. I didn't realize we knew his name.
Mm-hmm.
About it, David. Please stop walking away from us. I want to make sure everything's alright. Can you do me a favor and just sit down? We'll get this all sorted. Do us a favor and sit down, please. David. Please, just sit down.
Ah, great.
How about this, actually, because now it's decided to rain. Why don't we go over to my truck and you sit in the front seat? So we're out the rain. Like that. Edward.
Charger around. There it is.
What happened after that?
happened after that, David? How about this? I'll still ask you 1,000 questions because that's probably just going to get annoying. Let's sort this out. Let's clean you up. Let's get that gray steel side sorted. Out the weather. And then we can figure this out a lot slower out the rain. How about that? Yeah, so that warmer, you know, something to eat and drink as well. Cleaned up and take this a bit slower and yeah.
Man, I'm gonna be honest with you. I'm not gonna kind of sit around here and just watch this go back and forth constantly the whole time.
Give him. Just give him that chance. We'll go off of ours.
Oh no, I'm just. Then. All I'm saying is I'm just getting tired, like, actually.
Oh, right. Okay. Yeah, no, we'll call it a scene, hopefully. I think ours is making good progress with him, though.
He is not getting in the TRX without a cage.
Oh yeah, no, that's fair.
99, you better not be putting him into a vehicle without a cage.
Do you not have a vehicle with a cage?
You got mine.
Your truck doesn't.
Doesn't it?
Right. No. Yeah. Oh my God. Do you want to put him in mine, Az?
Yeah, we can go in this one.
Yeah.
Do it. Yeah. Maybe in the back of this charger.
Yeah. Alright, mate. I'll go ahead and unlock it for you. There you go. Alright.
Let's just straight to station, then we'll take it from there indoors.
Yeah, okay, no worries. Yeah. Okie dokes. Right. Alright, David, just to let you know, I'm just going to take you to Sandy Shore's Sheriff's Office, okay? We'll get you looked after in there, okay? When it's a bit more warm and dry, okay? Do you understand what I'm telling you? Okay, don't do that. Don't hurt yourself, mate. Alright. Right, guys, I think I'll call after this as well, to be honest, because, yeah. Do you remember where you've been today? Anything like that? I'm sorry, say that again.
Home.
Okay, where's home for you? 123, Sandy SI. Alright, go ahead, hop out, Dave. Thank you, buddy. Right, right this way, mate.
This way, this way.
Bloody hell.
Let's pull out the ladder.
Yeah, right. We've taken downstairs or?
Basically, anywhere that's got a decent amount of room.
Well, the cells would.
Wow, yeah, the big sets here we could do.
Yeah. Not necessarily going to be... Or we can take him into one of the interrogation rooms. It's not like they're being used at the minute.
Yeah, it's just a wee bit tight.
Is it?
I mean, it's not the best. Okay. Yeah, in the cells.
Alright, let me check.
It's not the best.
7-5, a good one.
User disconnected from your channel.
I will go one of these instead, because cells are cells, they don't... You're not in trouble, just let you know you're not in trouble. Otherwise we'd talk about that, alright?
Hey, Az. Over good. Here, mate.
Oh, fair enough.
Yeah. Alright. Shove him in here, mate. Alright. Gotta take a seat, Dave.
Will that be on a chair on the floor? Either or.
Yeah, just make yourself comfy.
Where's the... Oh, god damn, you're making me on there.
What's
the female's name that you mentioned again, David?
Stuff.
Her. She took away your tiger mask. Right.
Want her not to.
What happened after that? Well, it explained that to me actually. I'll just double check over that injury you've got. If you're feeling uncomfortable at any point in time, let me know. If you want me to take the mask off as well, I can do. It's just I'm pretty sure you've interacted with me more with this on than without, so...
Gunshot. There's gunshots.
Is that her or you shooting, or is it someone else?
Window.
What was that?
Window.
Someone shot through the window? Okay, then what happened?
As I'm going to leave this to you, mate. I'm going to have to go.
Alrighty.
Alright. Look after yourself, guys. Alright, guys. We're going to call it there, because I'm actually starting to doze off here. So, apologies for that. But yeah, hope you enjoyed today's episode. Nothing too hectic. Just a couple of investigative type calls, to be honest. But yeah. If you did enjoy the episode, obviously, like, rate, subscribe, all that good stuff. Appreciate all you guys who are obviously following me, subscribe to me, everything like that, and support. Excuse me, supporting me is a great help. But yeah. Until the next one, guys. Yeah. Sorry, guys. I'm tired. Yeah. Take it easy. Stay well. Take care, and I'll see you on the next one. In a bit, guys. Yeah.